No!
Unbelievable. Is this a nightmare?
You will not believe what happened to me with this virtuoso telescope and this tiny smart telescope, the Dwarf 2. The chances of this happening are very low, but I wonder, did you ever pass through this circumstance? I'm very curious about. It all started because I had a business to do in another town. And of course, I didn't want to stay inside the town because of the light pollution. However, I couldn't be so far away from the town, so I chose an hotel with all the facilities in the periphery. And I found one that fitted me, my wife and kids needs. Comfortable, near the town, and at a fair price, of course. However, as I needed the best darker position, after booking the apartment, I wrote them explaining that I would be with a telescope, thus my preference would be the darker side of the hotel. And they said, okay, I hope this time will be a better trip with a virtuoso telescope and not like the last time I did it, which was raining all the time. So I got my virtuoso telescope into the van, but as the dwarf is so tiny and light, I also decided to take it with us. You have the links at the description if you want to buy any of these telescopes. So far so good, here we go! The weather forecast was good for the two nights we will be there. So we arrived, we got the keys, and went through the resort to find the apartment. They respected my request, and they located us in the last buildings of the resort. However, at this moment I was not aware yet of what's going to succeed. Let's check the apartment.
Okay, the living room, kitchen.
This is the illuminated side, so I will not be placing the telescope here. It will have to be here, the back side from the kitchen. However, those two street lights later in the night will not help at all. But that wasn't the biggest problem. I can deal with the lights. Now let's pick the 6-inch virtuoso. Carefully, don't let it fall. This will be where the telescope will be placed tonight. But for now, let's store it in a safe place. Like for instance, the living room. That's it, well done. We don't want the dust and the resident birds to mess with the telescope. Then after dinner, I started to prepare the setup. Power supply to the laptop. And as it was very cold outside, I passed the USB cable through the window. However, when I went outside, everything was falling apart. It was only when I found the big problem. I forgot the camera.
No!
Unbelievable. Is this a nightmare? Now I realize that I borrowed the 6-inch Dobsonian for nothing. But that was when the dwarf saved my night. And I just had to pull it out the box, then connect it, and then place it outside. Super easy, super fast. Now I could use this tiny smart telescope to watch the sky. However, I had to choose the best views, and those were pointing towards Ursa Major. So I decided to watch the boats and the cigar galaxy. So I just had to do the telescope calibration, set up the exposure to 15 seconds, the gain to 80, and the infrared to infrared pass, and push the go-to after selecting from the catalog. And then after choose 99 frames, it stacked all the frames to deliver me a beautiful image of those two galaxies. The dwarf could even capture a third and even smaller galaxy, NGC 3077, the Garland Galaxy. So I ended up with three galaxies in one image. Just a snapshot, no post-processing. But the night was still young, and I could capture more objects like the Planetary Nebula, Owl Nebula, and of course the comet C2022E3 that was already visible in the sky for a short period of time.
Anyway, you saw already the Dwarf 2 mini telescope in action, so click on this video over here if you're interested to know more about this tiny smart telescope.